Senate in Canberra is about to decide today whether or not they will proceed with plans to drug test welfare recipients. David Leyonhjelm, the Liberal Democrat, doesn't like the idea. He can tell you more because he joins me on Perth Live right now. Senator, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What is wrong with drug testing welfare recipients?
Well, the assumption is that if you test positive for drugs, that there's something wrong with you and you've got to be sent off for some kind of assessment to determine, you know, why you take drugs. Now, of course, there's lots of people who smoke dope or take something else, has no effect on their ability to operate, their ability to get a job, whether or not they're on welfare or anything else. Of course, there are some people who have problems with drugs, but obviously there's lots of people who don't, who still take them for recreational purposes.
But if they're fair dinkum, if they want to go and get a job, they want to clean themselves up and get off welfare, then surely they can give up whatever they're smoking, whatever they're injecting into themselves for a couple of months, a couple of weeks, or however long they've got to be living off the taxpayers' dime.
I don't think it's the government's business. If you want to smoke a joint instead of drinking, I think that's a perfectly legitimate choice. And it's not the government's business to be telling you, what you should do with your, in terms of your recreational pastimes. The only consideration that the government can legitimately claim is if you take drugs, and that includes alcohol, which affects your ability to get or keep a job. That's relevant. But they've left alcohol out of this drug testing proposal that they're talking about. They've only included illegal drugs, and that includes cannabis. That's not legitimate. Alcohol can affect your ability to get and keep a job far, far worse than cannabis can, and yet cannabis is in the testing and alcohol is not.
All right, what if the government changed the legislation and they included alcohol? Would it get you support?
Only if they made it so that it was above a threshold level. In other words, above the level at which you are adversely affected in terms of employability. That's where it becomes relevant. So if you drink alcohol or smoke dope, and it doesn't affect your employability, it's no business of the government. If it does affect your employability, then it is the business of the government, and they then have a right to say to you, okay, then you've got to clean yourself up so that you are employable.
But this won't happen, will it? Because at the moment, and as you say, dope included, is an illegal drug in Australia.
Yes, well, that's the problem. It's not illegal in an increasing number of countries around the world, but yes, Australia seems to think that we're different. We seem to do that on so many subjects that people are different in Australia from the rest of the world, and we can ignore what happens in other countries. But this is the third time this current bill, which was listed for debate in the Senate today, although we're not going to get to it. This is the third time they've tried this issue under two ministers. And the first two times they got told, no, you're not going to do it. We're not going to agree to it. They got told by me, by many of the others on the crossbench, by Labor and the Greens, that no, we're not going to cooperate with this. I don't think they've got the support this time either. It's mostly just chest thumping, saying they're tough on drugs. Well, you know, you can be tough on drugs that matter, but being tough on drugs just for the sake of it, I don't think it's going to win them any votes, and it's got no basis in fact anyway.
All right, we'll see what the talkback lines think right now and open them up. Senator Leyonhjelm, thank you.
My pleasure.